In this video, we'll discuss about locking plates versus non-locking plates. Okay, we'll generally nowadays we are using non-locking plates. That means the main difference between locking and non-locking is in the locking plates. You can see this diagram. These are the locking plates and these are the non-locking plates. Locking plates means the screw gets locked against the plate. And there are threads in the screw head and the plate's hole. Okay, there are threads in the plate's hole as well as screw's head. You can see here. Okay, first we'll generally see about non-locking plates. In non-locking plate, this is the non-locking plate. This is the screw. These are the threads. This is the head part. In the head part, there is no threads. The head gets adapted to the underlying bone in the plate's hole. Okay, so this is the plate hole. There is no threads in the plate hole also. But whereas in the case of locking plates, there are threads in the screw's head. These red lines are the threads in the screw's head. Okay, and there are threads in the hole also. This is the cut section showing internal aspect of the hole in the pallet. Okay, in the plate. So there are threads in the hole. The screw head gets locked against these threads in the plate hole. Okay, this is the major difference between locking plate and non-locking plate. So coming to the advantages of locking plate, there is no need to contour the plate to the bone's surface. Okay, generally what we do is, when you are using non-locking plates, we have to ensure that there is intimate contact between the underlying bone and the plate. Okay, if this is the underlying bone and this is the fracture site, okay, the plate must be exactly contoured to the underlying bone like this. That means there must be exact contact between the bone and the underlying bone and the overlying plate, so that there is no fracture fragment overriding or there are no gaps in between the bone fragments. If you fail to do like that, when you are fixing the plate, there may occur the bone fragments overriding and lingual cortex side opening also. Okay, that problem is avoided in case of locking plate, because the screw gets locked against the thread, against the threads in the hole. So there is no need to exactly make the adaptation to the underlying bone. This advantage is especially helpful in the cases of reconstruction plate fixation, because you can't exactly adapt the reconstruction plate to the underlying bone because it is very tough and rigid. Okay, you cannot bend that much easily. In that case, this advantage is useful. And one more advantage is, screws do not get loose. Okay, if there is infection or if there is loose screw when you are fixing the plate, that must be changed with the emergency screw. That means if you are fixing a 2mm screw and it gets loosen, okay, in that case you have to use higher number screw, remove the 2mm screw and fix the 2.5mm screw. Because when there is loose screw in the fracture area, it promotes the infection chances. Okay, so that disadvantage of non-locking plate is also avoided in the locking plates, because screws are locked against the plate, so it can't get loose. So the screws do not get loose, then there is decreased chances of infection, right? And the third advantage of locking plate is greater stability when compared to the non-locking plates. It has greater stability, it provides greater stability at the fracture site. Okay, these are the main three advantages of locking plates. Generally, locking plates are indicated in cases of infected fractures, when there is already infection at the fracture site, and comminuted fractures. In these fractures, generally locking plates are advised. But the theoretical advantages has to be proven with clinical studies. But now, as per now, we are generally using non-locking plates only. Locking plates are reserved for some cases of infected fractures or comminuted fractures. We can use locking plate in any case, but nowadays we are not using. We are generally preferring non-locking plates only. Okay, so this is all about locking plates versus non-locking plate. If you like this video, hit the like button, share the video, subscribe the channel.